Good morning. Today we are going to discuss the concept of electric potential.
Flippin' physics.
We already learned that two charges have an electric potential energy which equals the Coulomb constant times charge 1 times charge 2 divided by the distance between the centers of the two charges. There is also something called electric potential. Electric potential describes the electric potential energy per unit charge at a point in space. The symbol for electric potential is uppercase V. And the general equation for electric potential is that electric potential equals electric potential energy divided by charge. Because electric potential is energy per unit charge, its units are joules per coulomb, to which we have given the name of volts. Volts are named after the Italian physicist Alessandro Volta, who was a pioneer of electricity and power. He is credited with the invention of the electric battery. And the symbol we use for volts is uppercase V. Billy?
So the symbol for electric potential is uppercase V, and the units for electric potential are volts, for which we use the symbol uppercase V. In other words, the symbol we use for electric potential and the symbol we use for the units for electric potential are the same?
Yeah, sorry.
It's okay. I'm sure it's not your fault.
Thanks. Okay, to help us understand electric potential, let's start with a simple electric potential energy example. Billy, please read the question, and Bo, please solve the question.
Example A. Charge 1 of positive 6.0 microcoulombs and charge 2 of positive 9.0 microcoulombs are 3.0 meters apart. What is the electric potential energy of the two-charge system?
Okay. Our knowns are charge 1 equals positive 6.0 microcoulombs. However, we are going to need that to be in coulombs because the Coulomb constant is in terms of coulombs. So multiply by 1 coulomb over 1 times 10 to the 6 microcoulombs because there are 1 million microcoulombs in 1 coulomb. That means charge 1 equals positive 6 times 10 to the negative 6 coulombs. Charge 2 equals positive 9.0 microcoulombs. And we can do the same conversion to get the charge 2 equals positive 9 times 10 to the negative 6 coulombs. And R, the distance between the centers of the two charges, is 3.0 meters. And electric potential energy is what we are solving for, so that equals question mark. Electric potential energy equals the Coulomb constant times charge 1 times charge 2 all over the distance between the centers of charge. You can substitute in 9 times 10 to the 9 for the Coulomb constant and all the other numbers I just identified. And we get 0.162 or 0.16 joules with 2 sig figs.
Thank you. Now, Bobby, please read and solve the next example.
Okay, what is the electric potential at a distance of 3.0 meters from a charge of positive 6.0 microcoulombs? Well, Bo already identified a bunch of knowns, so I'm not going to repeat those. Mr. P, you told us electric potential equals electric potential energy over charge. So all we have to do is divide 0.162 joules by 9 times 10 to the negative 6 coulombs. And we get 18,000 joules per coulomb, or 18,000 volts.
Thank you, Bobby. And just to get used to conversions, let's convert this to kilovolts. Just like there are 1,000 grams in 1 kilogram, there are 1,000 volts in 1 kilovolt. So let's multiply by 1 kilovolt over 1,000 volts to get 18 kilovolts. However, realize we do not actually need the information about charge 2 to determine the electric potential at a distance of 3.0 meters from the center of charge 1. Electric potential equals electric potential energy divided by charge. We can substitute the equation for electric potential energy into that equation. And for the charge in the denominator of the equation, we can use charge 2 because that is the charge we are removing from this scenario. And we get that the electric potential at a distance from the center of charge 1 equals the Coulomb constant times charge 1 divided by the distance from the center of charge 1 to the location where we are determining the electric potential. That equals 9 times 10 to the 9 times 6 times 10 to the negative 6, all divided by 3. And we get the same 18,000 volts, or 18 kilovolts. In other words, there exists, at a location 3.0 meters from a positive 6.0 microcoulomb charge, an electric potential of positive 18 kilovolts. And if we were to put a positive 9.0 microcoulomb charge at that location, the two-charge system would have an electric potential energy of 0.16 joules.
Or we could put a positive 18.0 microcoulomb charge at the same location and determine the new electric potential energy of the new two-charge system. It would be 18 times 10 to the negative 6 times 18,000, or 0.324, or 0.32 joules with two sig figs.
Exactly.
Nice!
Right. Knowing the electric potential at a location makes it easier to determine what the electric potential energy would be for any charge value. So, I can now identify that electric potential is the potential to have electric potential energy. At that location, 3.0 meters from the center of the positive 6.0 microcoulomb charge, there is an electric potential of positive 18 kilovolts. That 6.0 microcoulomb charge by itself does not have electric potential energy, but locations near the charge have electric potential. The potential to have electric potential energy. And when a second charge is added at that location, we can multiply that second charge by the electric potential to get the electric potential energy of the two-charge system. Okay, again, the equations for electric potential are, the general equation is electric potential equals electric potential energy over charge, and the electric potential caused by a point charge equals the Coulomb constant times the charge divided by the distance from the center of the charge to the location of the electric potential. And notice, that means there is a concentric spherical surface around the positive 6.0 microcoulomb charge, which has an electric potential of positive 18 kilovolts. It looks like a circle on the screen. However, it is actually a three-dimensional spherical surface with a radius of 3.0 meters, which surrounds the positive 6.0 microcoulomb charge. And on that entire spherical surface, the electric potential equals positive 18 kilovolts. And because R, the distance from the center of the charge, is in the denominator of the equation, as the location of the electric potential gets farther from the charge, the electric potential decreases. And as the location of the electric potential gets closer to the charge, the electric potential increases. Okay, there is a lot more I have to say about electric potential, like it is a scalar, how the electric potential works when we have more than one charge, and equipotential surfaces. Luckily, there is a lot more we get to learn about this.
Yay!
Yay.
Yay. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.